What's up, guys? Frank here with Michael Poulsen, who you may recognize from Volbeat, but he's tearing shit up with his new death metal project, Asinhell, and their new record coming out September 29th. Michael, it's great to talk to you. I gotta tell you, I'm absolutely loving the new record.
Thank you so much, man. Appreciate it. Thank you.
I mean, as soon as I heard Fall of the Loyal Warrior, I knew it was the real deal. You know, I mean, like, you always run that risk of like, oh, okay, so somebody you've known to do something for so long is trying something different. You don't really know how it's going to go. But, you know, it really reminded me of my favorites growing up, you know, Death and Bolt Thrower. And, you know, I know that you have been a fan of death metal for a long time. And of course, you know, you had Dominus before. And, but I do know that everyone has their entry points and their favorites along the way. I was wondering, what's your experience with death metal? How did you get into it?
Well, first of all, thank you for the great compliments. I appreciate it. I discovered heavy metal when I was around 10. And the more extreme part of music, I believe I discovered when I was 13. And that was, you know, that was bands like Battery and Venom and Celtic Frost. And you know, then discovering Death, Scream, Bloody Gore. And, you know, then the adventure pretty much starts there. Because then suddenly, I believe the first extreme record that I bought, that I just didn't only have on cassette, but the first extreme vinyl that I bought was Possessed Seven Churches. And from then on, it was like so many bands came out of the U.S. and especially Florida, you know all about it. So I was totally following Death and the beginning of, you know, of Autopsy and Malevolent Creation, Obituary, as I can see on your shirt. Those great legendary bands really had a deep impact on me. Of course, also as a Scandinavian, growing up with those great legendary Scandinavian bands like Entombed and Dismember and Grave and Carnage, Nihilist and Necrophobic, and you know, the list continues. So many great bands, and early Dark Throne. And I remember we were also very crazy about the early Benediction, you know, the classic Subconscious Terror album with Bonnie on vocals, and Gorefest from Holland, you know. And you remember how it was, you know, back in those days, there was not that many releases. So today, every week, there's, I don't know how many releases, it's tough to keep up with. But back in the days when you were tape trading and going into vinyl stores, nerding around, you know, there was only a few releases every month. So it was something really, really special. I believe I was around 13 when I started listening to extreme music. And I was probably around 15 when I started playing death metal, and which later became my first band, Dominus, where we released four albums on a small Danish label.
I mean, I guess the obvious question here is, you know, you do have Volbeat, which is just such a successful band that's seemingly always working on something. Why was now the time to break out another band? And, you know, and especially why was it, you know, going back to death metal for you?
There's still extremely a lot of work to be done in Volbeat. And next year we will be writing and recording a new album. But at the same time, I'm going out playing live shows with Asinhell. Volbeat are not playing live next year, but we are going to write a new album and record it. I guess to answer your question is a lot of musicians during the pandemic suddenly have the time to sit down and reflect on everything they've done in the past or what they want to do in the future, what they were doing at the moment. And it's, I guess it was the same thing with me when I start writing the Sermon of the Mind album with Volbeat. I wrote that album pretty fast. In like 3 months, everything was done with the material, and we only ended up recording in, I believe we were in the studio for 7 or 10 days or something. And I was just on fire. And at the same time, during that period with the Volbeat record, I lost a very good close friend in LG Petrov from Legendary Entombed. And he did try to call me at a time where he was very sick. He was also sending a lot of videos where he was not doing good, but you know, he was still keeping the spirit up. But he did call me while I was in the supermarket and I didn't pick up. And later on, he called me during the night where I didn't pick up. And then the last thing I heard was that he passed away. And I was really, you know, I was really sad about that, mostly because I do believe that he wanted to give me a call and maybe say goodbye. So when we recorded Servant of the Mind with Volbeat, we ended up dedicating the song Becoming for LG and Entombed, since the opening riff was pretty much inspired by Entombed, and we ended up putting that beautiful, ugly, disgusting bus pedal on top of it that makes that signature Swedish death metal sound that that we all know. And it just kind of put a fire in me. So when we went for the tour to promote the album, I just told my guitar tech to find the bus pedal so I could sit backstage and start writing some riffs. And that was basically it. It was just me wanting to do some riffing. And he said, are you going to form that death metal thing? And I don't think that's it's time yet. And just as we were talking about it, I had my iPods out of nowhere, just like having a pocket call from your iPhone, start playing Full of Hell with Entombed. And I pretty much took that as a call from LG. And I told myself, this time, Michael, you're fucking picking up. And so for me, that was a call from LG telling me to shut up and start working on that death metal thing again, instead of just talking about it. And I guess that's just the time for everything. It's just when people say they don't have the time to go to the gym. But you know what? If they really want to go to the gym, they'll go to the gym. And I guess, you know, it's this also really started because I got so much inspiration from that pocket call that when I came home, I just started writing. I couldn't stop myself. And it just kind of felt like jumping on your bike again that you've been parking in the garage for so many years. And it's just been looking at you every time you went to the garage and passing it. And I've always been saying, yeah, one day I'll jump on you again and we'll get some things done. And it felt like yesterday jumping on that bike. And, you know, it feels good. And as I said, I've been listening to extreme music since I was 13, so it was easy to pick up the guitar again and just start riffing. It feels good, man. I'm really proud of it. I'm very proud of the lineup with my good friend Morten Soft Hansen on guitar. People maybe know him from Raunchy, and of course, if you're a death metal nerd, you definitely know Mark Clary, the singer from legendary German Morgoth, who's now in Insidious Disease. Our producer, Jacob Hansen, we know from Invocator, is playing the bass, and the lead guitar is done by Fleming Lund, which also go way back to when I was in Dominus. He has his old band called Autumn Leaves, and we were playing shows back in the days. He's doing the lead guitar. And it's done with some really, really good old friends. So it's been a lot of great fun. And we do share the same passion for that old school extreme music. So it was not really that tough. It felt quite natural.
First of all, that was just a beautiful story and sentiment. And, you know, the passing of LG really hit a lot of us, you know, I mean, as Entombed fans, and, you know, I knew him briefly, and he was such a great guy and fun to be around. And, but, you know, I didn't know that I'm glad that it was that, you know, I didn't know if it was like because there obviously is a resurgence of death metal with a lot of younger bands coming out. And, you know, like there's so many going on right now that are kind of like, I don't want to say repeating history, but they are kind of bringing it back, you know, and putting their stamp on it. I don't know if you keep up with any of the newer death metal bands that are coming out, or if it had anything to do with that.
Oh, yeah. I think that's a lot of great new death metal bands coming out. Definitely, you know, it seems like there's 10 new death metal bands every week, you know, and there's some really good bands in between. So yeah, I still like when I'm on tour with Volbeat, when there's time, we go out to the few vinyl record stores that's left, and it's just great to be able to find new great bands to be inspired by. So yeah, I definitely dig into some of the new stuff. I find very, very good. But the passion is definitely for the old school bands that was around late 80s, early 90s. But I'm definitely not taking anything away from the new bands, because I think they're doing an amazing job. There's a lot of great names out there.
And, you know, I find it interesting. I thought about, like, you and even Tobias Forge from Ghost. You both started in extreme metal and found your calling in more accessible hard rock. But I imagine that there's always got to be this itch to do something heavier along the way, right?
I don't know. You know, it's, for me, it's pretty much like eating food. You know, I know what I like, and I know what I like to dig into. I know what I want to try. You know what I know what I don't like, and everything I do is done with passion. You know, so it's all about following in your heart when you pick up the guitar and start writing. So I don't think too much about, you know, the reason why I formed Volbeat was because I needed to go on an adventure where I had some freedom to incorporate a lot of different styles that I couldn't incorporate in death metal. And that adventure has been going on for many, many, many years, where you can hear Volbeat combining everything from rockabilly, pop rock, metal, gospel, and stuff like that. That's something that we can't really incorporate in death metal without being fucking hanged on the upside down cross. So it was just time for me at that time to form Volbeat to, you know, satisfy myself for the curiosity of being a musician and trying a lot of different styles. But in the back of my mind, I always had the passion and love for extreme music. So I just knew, there was actually a lot of my friends who said, you're probably going to return to that one day. And I said, yeah, you know, it's definitely going to take some time because I'm so extremely busy with Volbeat. But getting back to your question, it's just like, everything's just done with passion. If it's rock music or death metal or pop rock, gospel, punk, blues, whatever it is, you know, I'll do it with passion, because, you know, that's what life is all about, figuring out what you like and what you don't like.
Very true. And, you know, I know that you, as you mentioned, you have Mark from Morgoth and Toph from Raunchy in the band as well. Can you tell us how it all came together? Was this something that you put together, or did they come to you, or how did that work out?
It was pretty much something I put together. I've been knowing Mark for many, many years, even all the way back to Morgoth. But we did start talking more when he joined Insidious Disease. You know, when back in the days when he fronted Morgoth, I had my own band at that time called Dominus. And we were having the same distributor in Copenhagen, Denmark. So we were in contact for a while. And then when he formed Insidious Disease, I was just mailing him and telling him it was good to see him back again in a great band. And we just kept contact and became really, really good close friends. And as so many others, you know, when we were sitting down and having a good time, we wanted one day to do this old school death metal band together. But I could definitely sense that Mark didn't have much belief in that, mostly because I was so extremely busy in Volbeat. Volbeat has been scaling down on live shows. So suddenly I could find the time for sitting down and open up the coffin for those death metal riffing again. So I always had Mark in mind to be the front man in this project. And my daughter is playing and having a good time with Maud, my drummer. His daughter, you know, we live only 10, 12 minutes away from each other. So now and then, you know, we were just having the kids playing around in the garden, and we just went into Morten's garage, and I saw he had his drums up. And I did mention him before that I probably wanted to start something very old school death metal at a time, and ask if that was something he was up to or into. He said, yeah, just give me a call when you're ready. And that was pretty much the same thing Mark told me. But when I saw Martin had his drums up in his garage, I said, all right, let's get started, because I'm fucking fire. Got a lot of riffs. So we hooked up every Friday. So Friday became Death Metal Friday before we had to pick up our kids from school and kindergarten. And I basically just wanted to keep it very simple. You know, I didn't want to move into any fancy panty rehearsal rooms where you get a little bit comfortable nowadays if you have the tools to do that. So we just stayed in Morten's garage and closed the windows and the doors, and it was so extremely hot in there, but there was no way that the neighbors were going to put up with all that noise we were bringing every Friday. So for a couple of hours, we'll be bringing that old metal, and every Friday we kind of pretty much had a new song. It's no PA system, just Morten's drums and an old amp from my basement, and an old rusty guitar from back in the days when I was in Dominus. And then we just recorded the songs on my iPhone and sent it to Mark. And that was extremely noisy, but that's how we wanted it. He said, yeah, I want it to sound totally authentic, how you guys are actually doing it. No reason for making anything sound nice or anything, because that's not how it's supposed to be. So I just did some demo growling down to my iPhone in the small garage, so Mark had an idea how and where I wanted to put down the vocals. And very quickly, he figured that out. He's extremely talented, and his voice is one of the best. And before we knew, we were in the studio, and I don't think we were there for a week. We were probably there for 5 or 6 days, and it was all in the box. We pretty much recorded it live. Me and Morten went in guitar, drums, and then I adopted a few guitars to add a more thick sound. Mark came in and put down the vocals in the studio, and producer Jacob Hansen put down his bass on one day in the studio, and Fleming, the lead guitar player, were recording his live thing. His lead guitar, and we basically just wanted to sound like something that was released late 80s, early 90s, and not, you know, do too much about the sound. Of course, we all have the experience now. We control our instruments way better than we did when we were 16 or 17. But I think the end result is really, really great, and I think Jacob Hansen as a producer nailed it. I think he did amazing work with this sound that we came up with.
You mentioned that, you know, you always had Mark in mind as, you know, a front man for this project. You know, you also said that you did some growling on what would be the iPhone demo, I guess. Was it a conscious effort to not be a vocalist on this project? Was it always going to be Mark, or you just knew that you just didn't want to sing on it?
I always only had Mark in mind, you know, even though that I was a front man in Dominus back in the day and doing the growling, and I had never any attention about reforming Dominus. I knew if I was going back to death metal, it would be by a new name with new members and with Mark as a front man. So I never really had myself in mind. You know, I'm extremely busy being a frontman in Volbeat, and I'm having a great time doing that. But when it came to Asinhell, I never had myself in mind. That was all about Mark and just me writing the music and being on the right side playing the guitar.
And speaking of vocals, of course, we know that you have an operation procedure coming up, and that's generally right. But it sounds like it's all hopeful, and you're going to come back bigger and stronger afterwards, right?
I have to. I'm very optimistic. And I had the operation before. This time is just a little bigger operation, but I'll be all right. I'm very optimistic about everything. It's gonna take some work to get back to vocal shape, but I tried it before. I had good people around me to be able to do the right thing. Vocal coach in Melissa Cross, and there's gonna be some time for me to get back in vocal shape, so I can go out again with Volbeat and record a new album with a total new throat. So I'm just staying very optimistic about the whole thing. So I do not worry about it too much because I've been there before. It's just a bigger thing, a bigger operation this time. But I'll make it, and it's gonna work. It have to.
Awesome, cool. That's great to hear, man. And I imagine after 20 years of working on Volbeat music, it's got to be refreshing and exciting to work on something like Asinhell. And now that it's in the can and it's being released this week, what would you say is something that you learned about the process of doing Asinhell that you might take into Volbeat territory someday?
It's actually a very interesting question because I've thought about it, but I haven't come to any conclusion yet. I think that's something that I will figure out maybe when I sit down and write the next Volbeat album or going into the studio. We were, if you and I are doing an interview at the time where the Volbeat record is about to be released, it would probably be more easier to answer a question like that.
Are you going to do tours, like do touring in the States or anything like that? Is there any plans?
We're definitely going on the road next year playing shows. That's something that we're working on now. And that's going to be more releases from Asinhell. So, we will try to do as much as we possibly can. We're all busy individuals having other bands or other kinds of work, and we all had kids. So, we did promise ourselves to try to break a record playing more shows than Dark Throne. So that's a start.
Right. Well, we can't wait to see it, man. Till then, we have the record and it's fantastic. And, good luck and congratulations. And I wish you, a speedy recovery from the operation and everything.
Thank you so much. I appreciate it.